Hey everybody, it's Bob Boob, the real estate guy. All right, hi, this is Bob Boob, the real estate guy. I like my hoodie there. Yep, see, I'm at 169 Campground Road. 169 Campground Road over in Logington is the zip code. I'm actually in Logan Township near Logington. And if you're not familiar with Logington, it's in Clinton County, Pennsylvania, near Route 80. 880 is the route that goes through it. Then, did you hear that Logington is getting a McDonald's and a Starbucks? Nope, just kidding. It's not getting that. It has a store and it's got a little restaurant and it's good just the way that it is. This is a place out in the country here. This got about 2 acres with it. I think it's 2 acres on the button. And kind of showing you the yard here. And the house sits here. It is big. Wait till I take you inside here. This could either work for somebody that needs a lot of rooms, maybe you have a larger family, or you just have a lot of stuff you need storage space for. I guess if you're maybe looking at this from outside of the area, could even be good for maybe a camp, you know, where you have a couple people going together. Got central air here. There's the unit right there. There's a build code door that goes down into the basement area. We'll go down the dungeon a little bit. Carport here, of course. Super cool, awesome Jeep. That's not included with the sale. I'm thinking this blue shed is part of it. I'm doing this video tour for the awesome Bev Fisher from Century 21 First Choice Realty. There's a little barn. You can put your in-laws in there if you don't really like them very well when they stay over. So if you have any questions on this house, please reach out to Bev. Her number will be somewhere at the top or bottom of the screen here a couple times as I do the video tour. But I'm just going to kind of give you a walkthrough of the property. But nice country location. You're going to see here a set of steps that will take us up to the second floor. That'll all come together eventually as we do the tour. You're going to see here from this carport, it's actually really, I don't know if I can show you this here. See, it's really like two carports together, so that's a really nice Silverado truck there. That's not included with the sale, but you can see you could park two of those nose-to-nose very easily. Of course, then you have a nice deck here. This comes out to back here as the deck. Now, you're going to see at one time they had a pool right here, but of course, that's gone, unless you just want to swim in that little mud hole there. That's Fishing Creek towards that direction. I think right now I'm facing north. That would be west, south, and of course the other side would be east. Sorry if I got that goofed up there. But let's go inside and take a look around. As I mentioned, this is a really nice sized property. I'm not sure that would work for the government programs the way it is. There is some things that would probably make you do, but maybe not the end of the world stuff. If you're handy, I suppose you could do that. But when you first walk in, you walk into a laundry room, mud room area, which is nice to kind of kick off your shoes, and then you step into a really nice size eat-in kitchen with lots of cabinet space. See that? Look on the spec sheet whether the appliances are included or not. I think they are, but please don't hold me to that. I can be incorrect. I guess if the price is right, they're included, huh? The price isn't right, they're not included. Now there's two baths in the house, and this is, of course, first floor bath. Full bath has the shower in there. Of course, vanity. I think that's a 3-footer. And toilet, got the throne. And then this is just a, yep, linen closet with lots of goodies in there. So again, still the kitchen area. As I'm walking around here, if you're not familiar again with Logington, Logington is a really nice community. As I mentioned before, Clinton County, real close to 80. A lot of people that live over here year-round, they work Lewisburg, State College, Williamsport, Sunbury. Sometimes one person's heading one way and then the other person's heading another. You're going to see that this room is big, guys. Oh my gosh, Chris, halfway, that's got to be 15. I'm going to stand back to back here. That's got to be 25, 30 feet across that double room. It looks like the windows are the replacement ones. I don't know how old they are. Looks like, I don't know if that one's the gas broke or if it just needs clean. But they're not the old windows anyhow. But nice size room. Then there's a room I guess I'll call it a den. Just kind of a catch-all or storage area for the owner right now. But it's a nice size room. It's probably 11 by 11. And then here we're looking back on that deck. So here I'm heading or facing west then. So nice size deck area. I suppose it could be a separate dining room area or a little TV room. Just depends, I guess, how big your family is. All right, let me think here what to do next. You know, I'm going to do this backwards. Let me take you down in the basement first. I'll push pause and then I'll take you upstairs. Okay, be right back. Okay, I'm walking down in the basement and looks like, I'm going to say this, maybe this house had an addition done on it one time. You're going to see here, this is block. I'm coming down, of course, I'm trying not to hit my head here as I'm talking to you. Of course, there you can see the old stone foundation and where the block is, because this is all like newer here. Remember that Bilco door we saw on the outside? That would be on that side or the driveway side. So of course, and it's got newer plastic plumbing in there. Nice storage shelf there. And of course, this is a, I don't know if it's wood and coal, multi-fuel or what, but it says Brunco, B-R-U-N-C-O, and that looks like a nice unit. So I'm going to tell you it's a wood stove, but could do coal too. I'm just not 100% sure here today. And then there's electric hot water heater. And of course, now we have the old part of the foundation, or the stone foundation. Now this has a newer looking gas furnace here. That's propane. They don't have natural gas out here in this area. Boy, that'd be nice if they did, but propane's good. And then you have a breaker box with no light in the corner, but that's a breaker box. Jeez, guys, I'm trying to see it here. Oh yeah, that's a big line coming in here. I think that's a 200 amp service. So maybe we'll have to double check that with the owner, but I think that's 200 amps. So that's the dungeon. So again, a good just combination of walls here. Some of them are concrete, some of them are block, but yeah, there we go. So let me think here. Yes, I'm gonna push pause and we're gonna go upstairs and look around. Okay, so I'm still at 169 Campground Road in Logan. I'm in the second floor here now. Now you're gonna see some of these rooms, we're gonna see the remnants of the older part of the house. So I'm gonna have to make up some room names here. This looks like, I guess if somebody was to make an apartment up here, if that's okay with the zoning, this maybe would be maybe a good kitchen area or living room area. That's the door that takes us up to the attic. The attic is real short up there. Maybe if you're like a Smurf size, you could stand up there. But the unit, you can see here, for the central air, you can see some of the ductwork is right above us there. So then I come here and I have a small bedroom. I'm gonna say 8 foot by 11 foot possibly for that. Then we come into a big bathroom area. Of course, it has the big shower here. And of course, there's the throne and the vanity, and there's an ugly guy in the mirror waving at you. But then look at this, off the bathroom, of course, so they call this a captured bedroom. There's another bedroom. This is probably 12, 13 by 11. So this again is a nice size room. So another room upstairs here. So that gives us one room, bathroom, two room, three room and bathroom. And then we come down the hall. Now here I'm walking towards south or towards the driveway side. All right, so here we have this big, I guess more of a closet or storage area since there's no windows in here. But this is really, really nice size. This is probably 6, 12, 18, but at least about 20 foot deep here. So then we end up with room number, what am I on, 4 here. So this is a nice size bedroom area. Kind of do the spin around here, has a closet. And you're gonna see it's got diffusers in the ceiling. So it looks like those have been installed. And then what is that, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This would be room number 5, correct? Imagine that, a realtor being able to count to 5. And again, it's got, you'll see here, some of the newer windows here. And again, that's that view across the street. Cool farm with the cows and stuff, but nice, nice country view out here. Not many close neighbors. And then I want to show you out here. Let's see what we got going on here. This is that door. Oh, it's locked. good realtor would have had that unlocked, but I didn't. So this is bringing us out to the side. Just kind of give you an idea where we're at. So I'm not sure what the intentions were of the current owner, but it certainly gives you some versatility. Give you kind of a view there of the 2 acres that you have with this property. Again, Beth Fisher, she's super cool, awesome, and she's the listing agent on this. Reach out to her. Like I said, her numbers will be in the video and online and that sort of thing like that. If you want to get a showing of the property, or maybe you have questions on financing, because this one will get a little creative, because as you can see with the work that needs to be done, it's not, I don't really say it's clear as mud with how the loan will work, but we know ways to do that. All right. Hey, thank you very much. Have a great day. Talk to you later. Thanks for watching the video.